In example 1.3.10, now we're going to look at the type of sampling. Can we identify the type of sampling used based on the scenario? So for scenario A, a soccer coach selects 6 players from a group of boys aged 8 to 10, 7 players from a group of boys aged 11 to 12, and 3 players from a group of boys aged 13 to 14 to form a recreational soccer team. Well, notice how we are choosing from different groups. We've got a group of boys aged 8 to 10, a group from 11 to 12, and another group from 13 to 14. We're not picking all the players from each of those groups. We're only picking some of the players. So some of the players from each group would be a stratified sample. We've got the different strata, the ages of the boys, and we're taking some from every group. We have a stratified sample. Part B, a pollster interviews all human resource personnel in 5 different high-tech companies. Here, we're interviewing all personnel in some company. So it's not stratified. Stratified is some from every group. In scenario B, we're doing all personnel from some of the companies. This is a cluster sample. Part C, a high school educational researcher interviews 50 high school female teachers and 50 high school male teachers. So here we're splitting the high school teachers into 2 groups, and we're selecting some from each group. This is a stratified sample. In scenario D, a medical researcher interviews every 3rd cancer patient from a list of cancer patients at a local hospital. Since we're selecting every 3rd, we're skipping some systematically. So this is a systematic sample. Anytime we're counting over a certain number, we're doing this systematically. E, a high school counselor uses a computer to generate 50 random numbers and then pick students whose names correspond to the numbers. Well, in this case, we're not doing some students from all the classes or all the students from some of the classes, so it's not stratified or cluster. We're not doing every so many students, so it's not systematic. This is a simple random sample. We're just generating 50 random numbers and then selecting those 50 students that correspond to those numbers. And in scenario F, a student interviews classmates in his algebra class to determine how many pairs of genes a student owns on the average. Since the student is only interviewing people in his algebra class and not looking at the entire school or the entire population of students, this is a convenient sample. He's only looking at his class and getting information from that class. So it's convenient.